Good morning, everyone. It's no mistake that the gag grouper of the Gulf Coast is found in much of the same habitat as the red snapper. That's why this fish has been so successful in the northern Gulf. There's a host of other fish listed under the grouper classification of reef dwellers. Unlike the other fish in the grouper family, the gag grouper prefers hard rock bottoms, man-made reefs, oil rigs, and wrecks, rather than the natural coral structures found in South Florida. Gag grouper are often mistaken as black grouper, and have two distinguishing characteristics that make them identifiable. First is a slightly concave-shaped tail, rather than the flat or rounded tail found in other grouper. The second, and harder to discern, is an olive-colored body marked with a darker erratic worm pattern of splotches. The black grouper has a similar yet more defined block pattern. A mature gag grouper will be over 2 feet in length and range upwards in a 30-pound range. Fishing closures on the gag grouper have been implemented in the Gulf of Mexico, citing their numbers are declining, along with those of the red snapper. Ongoing challenges to that data have created some valid disputes for both of these species. Opponents state that the information collected on snapper and gag grouper is inaccurate due to where and how sample counts were being taken. Like the red snapper, the gag grouper is a highly prized fish for recreational anglers who enjoy their reef fishing. The good news about the gag grouper is that it comes back in season this September 16th and runs through November 16th. For more information, go to gulfcouncil.org. I'm Gary Finch for 3 in the morning.